Hello everyone. In last session we discussed about the topic nature of matter. In that we learned about states of matter. Okay, observe students, observe the diagrams. Yes, can you recall particles arrangement? Yes, particles arrangement in matter. Okay, can you identify which matter is there? Which state of matter? Yes, particles are tightly and densely array or particles are orderly arrangement. It is the arrangement of particles in solid. Solid in solid matter, particles are orderly or tightly arranged. Next, observe the second diagram. How particles are arranged? Particles are loosely arranged. Means the particles which are loosely arranged compared to the solid, we call as which matter? Yes, it is a liquid. State of matter is liquid. Next, observe third one picture. How particles are arranged compared to the liquid? Here, particles are rarely arranged. Can you recall the meaning? Yes, particles are rarely arranged means belongs to gas. State of matter is gas. See students, state of matter is classified into three types: solid, liquid, and gas. Okay, here solid, liquid, and gas. Can we change the state of matter? Yes. In last class we learned that we can change the state of matter from solid to liquid and liquid to gas. Okay. How? And now I have some solid matter. I need to convert as liquid. How can we convert solid into liquid? Yes, exactly. By heating. See, when we heat in solid substances or solid matter, it converted into liquid. Here we can say that effect of heat. What we say? Effect. Effect of heat on matter. Effect of heat on matter means first we have solid matter. When we are heating solid matter, it converted into liquid. Without heating, it does not convert into liquid form. So we say that effect of heat. Heat on, here it is a solid matter. We are heating solid matter, it converted its states into liquid form. Okay, this is the effect of heat on matter. If we convert heat, liquid matter into gas form, how can we convert? Yes, again we need to heat. Heating effect helps to convert the state of matter. If we again heat liquid matter, it converted into gas form. This is effect of heat on matter. Can you say example for effect of heat on matter? Which changes states? Yes, ice cube. First, ice cube is in solid form. When we are heating or putting for in atmospheric temperature, it starts melting. What happens? It starts melting. If again the liquid substance, it converts as vapor form. Okay, then it converted as vapor form. This is change in state of matter. Change in state of matter because of heat. So we say the effect of heat on matter. See students, is our state of matter is converted as solid to liquid, liquid to gas? Yes? See, in some state of matter, solid substances are solid matter is directly converted into gas form. How? Solid is converted into gas. These types of changes we call as sublimation. We already learn sublimation. The matter which changes into solid into gas form or gas into solid form, these types of changes in matter we call as sublimation. Okay, students, we saw various matter in our surrounding. Is all the matter stars? Yes, in properties of matter, we learned that matter has mass. Okay, now we are going to learn about what is mass. Mass. Write down the meaning of mass. Mass. Mass is the total quantity, total quantity of matter cohering together to make an object or substance. What do you mean by mass? Mass is the total quantity of matter cohering together to make an object or substance. We call it as mass. Okay. Mass is measured in terms of weight. How mass is measured? Mass is measured in terms of weight. Okay. The SI unit of mass is SI unit of mass is. What do you mean by SI unit? SI unit is one of the standard unit which is used to measure the weight of an object or weight mass of an object. So how weight we measure? Yes, we measure weight in kilograms. Okay, kilogram is called as SI unit. Okay, kilogram. SI unit of mass is kilogram. Why we use kilogram? Because we are measuring weight in terms of kilogram. So we say that kilogram is one of the standard unit to measure the weight of a matter. So SI unit is kilogram. Here is kilogram. When we are going to write kilogram in word, we must write first letter must be capital. In short form or symbolic form, we write kilogram as kg. What do you mean by kg? Kg means K indicates kilo. K is kilo, G for gram. Okay. In short form or symbolic form, we wrote as kg. Okay, kilogram is also called as kg. Next, we move on density. Let's see the chart. See students, here 1 gram. 1 gram contains 1000 milligram or 1000 milligram we call as 1 gram. See, here the total quantity of matter. Total quantity of matter is 100 milligram. Here, cohering together to make an object or substance. By adding 1000 milligram of a substance or matter, we get some matter of 1 gram. Okay. Here, 1000 gram. 1000 gram is equal to 1 kg. Generally, we say 1 kilogram. Okay. Weight is measured in kg or kilogram. Kg. 1 kg contains 1000 grams. Next, 100 kg is equal to 1 liter and 1000. another concept, that is density. You know what it means by density? In topic nature of matter, we learn about all the matter and its nature. We know matter has mass, then matter has density also. What it means by density? Yes? See students, we have cotton and we have iron. Both the cotton and iron are looking same in quantity. Okay, only quantity is same, but the weight of cotton and weight of iron is same? No, weight of cotton is less, weight of iron is more. See, it is just imagine, it is a cotton, it is a metal. Both the objects are looking same, okay? Only for looking the objects are same. When we are weighing these objects, what happened? Cotton is in less weight. Metal has more weight compared to matter. Metal and cotton. Cotton has less weight. Metal has more weight. Means we say that less weighing object, less weight object we call as low density or less density. For the less weight object, density is less. For more weight object, density also more. Okay. More density. This is density. Just like this, students, we take a glass and 1/2 cup of water and take 1/2 glass of oil and both water and oil, shake it well together. Is water and oil mixed? Observe, water and oil mix together? No. Why? Water and oil is not mixed together? Yes. Because water density is more compared to the oil. So water density is more, so water is settled down. And oil density is very less compared to the water. That's why oil is floating on water. This is about density. Here, how can we measure density? For measuring density also, standard unit is there. The standard unit for density is kg per cubic meter. See, kg per cubic meter is the SI unit for density. What is the SI unit for density? SI unit for density is kg per cubic meter. Okay. Can we write the definition form? Yes. Let's see. Density means the mass of an object in meter of its volume. We call as density. See student, here the mass of an object we measure in kg. Okay, in 1 cubic meter of its volume. Cubic meter. Here power 3 is cubic meter. Mass of an object in 1 cubic meter of its volume we call as density. SI unit of density is kg density. For solid substances, solid has more density. More density. Solid has more density compared to the liquid. If we compare liquid, see solid, liquid and gas. These are the three states of matter. When we compare the density with solid and liquid, solid is strong. Okay, so solid has more weight. So we say that solid objects have more density compared to the liquid. Next, we compare liquid and gas. Liquid, in liquid, particles are more compared to the gas particle. So, liquid weight has more compared to the gas. So, we say that liquid has more density compared to the gas. Density is more for solid. When we are comparing with liquid, density is more for solid. When we are comparing liquid and gas, for liquid density is more. Less density for gas molecules. This is about density. Next we move on pressure. We have two beakers. Both the beakers are filled with water. Both the beakers are filled with water. Now we have blade. Okay. Now we are putting blade into the water. One blade is putting vertically on water. Horizontally on water. Okay. In second case, we are putting blade vertically in water. In both cases, we are putting blade into the water. In first case, when we are putting blade horizontally, blade will float on the surface. In second case, when we are putting blade into water vertically, vertically means we are putting blade in vertical form. Okay, that time blade will be seen. Why these differences? Blade have same weight or same mass. Then here blade is floating. Blade is seen. Why this happen? See, vertically means we are putting blade in this direction. Horizontal means we are putting blade in horizontal direction. In horizontal direction, blade will not sink. Instead of sinking of blade, blade will float. Why blade will float? See students, here particles are arranged. Here it covers wider area. So the blade weight is fall on the particles. Okay. It acts on the force, acts on the upper direction. That's why blade will not sink. Instead of sinking, blade will flow. It covers wider area or wider particles cover the blade. So, it's float. In vertical direction, blade will be seen. Why this happen? Because here particles are very less. Particles and area is inserted ane unit area we call as pressure. Here pressure is the force exerted ane on an unit area we call as pressure. When we are putting blade vertically the area wider area is covered so the blade will float. Here small area is covered in vertical direction so blade will be seen. This is about pressure. See students, instead of blade when we are putting objects into the water now again I have beaker. Now I have two beakers. Two beakers are filled with water or any liquid. If we put stone into the water what happens? Stone settles down. Okay, if I put plastic, some plastic objects are balls or wooden plank, it floats on the surface of water. In first case I put stone, stone is settled down. Okay, why it is settled down? Because the weight of stone is more and the density here. If the stone is seen, we say that the pressure act in a downward direction. Pressure act in downward direction. So the stone will sink. Okay, here plastic or wooden planks are floating on water. Or dry leaves, etc. These are floating on water. Means in this case, the pressure act on the upward direction. Pressure act on the upward direction. That time objects are floating. When the pressure act on a upward direction, the object starts floating. These types we call as buoyancy. We call as buoyancy. Buoyancy means pressure act in a upward direction. That time we call as buoyancy. See student, just imagine if you have a glass of water. Okay, you have, now you are going to add 2 teaspoons of sugar into the water. Then stir well. After some time sugar dissolves in water. Okay, sugar dissolve in water. Okay, in similar way, salt. Take a glass of water and take 1 teaspoon of salt and dissolve in water. What happened? Salt completely dissolve in water. Instead of sugar and salt, now you use 1 teaspoon of chalk powder or charcoal powder. Now you need to dissolve this powder into 1 glass of water. Is chalk powder or charcoal powder dissolved in water? Yes, think? No, chalk powder or charcoal powder not dissolved in water. Okay, here in case of salt and sugar, particles are completely dissolved. In case of charcoal and chalk powder, particles or matter is not dissolved in water. So that test we call as solubility. Solubility means matter which is dissolved in liquid or water completely we call as solubility. By using solid form, some are in liquid and gas form. This different nature of matter we studied in the topic nature of matter. In next class we are going to solve the activities given in your EVS book. I hope you understood the class nature of matter.